morning.
Good morning
once again. Praise God. Asante. I'm really glad to be here this morning to join the Kabianga High School fraternity for this morning session. Your principal, who is a very good friend of mine, we've worked this journey together since he came to this school. I'm very supportive of his leadership because it's the kind of leadership that can change a society and a nation like ours. So every time he extends an invite to me, I take it seriously. So the last few months, he has been on my case, saying that the boys of this year, our candidates for the year 2020, though, because of the unique situation that is happening across the globe, you do your exams in 2021, is a special lot. It's dear to him for reasons that you all know. And also he says, out of his gut feeling, he's certain you guys are going to break records in this school. I said, if the person who stays with a gallant young man on a daily basis has this kind of feeling, then who wouldn't wish to be part and parcel of that success? I want that come April or thereabouts, when we receive the results and you guys are at home celebrating, to at least claim some sense of ownership and say, I also did something. I went there one morning and motivated them and asked them to aspire to be great and all the things that we have done this morning. So that's the very reason why I came. My name is Aaron. I don't come from very far from here. My home is a place called Kapchebe. It's about maybe 10, 15 minutes walk or driving. You pass the yoga center, then the next place you get is where I come from. So I grew up in this locality, I know this school so well. I know the story of Kabianga. I know the tagline that you guys have taken, that it is a source of champions. That indeed, over the years, great men have come out of this institution. And I want to believe that in this assembly this morning, even greater men shall come out of you guys. So that's why I'm here. You guys are my young brothers. I don't think I can qualify to be your parent. So your young brothers to me. I want to address you as an elder brother, somebody who's been where you are and now is in where I am. I've been to this school many times. First, as a student, I went to Kericho High School. I didn't come to Kabianga. So, we used to come here so many times for so many things, sports, symposiums, Christian Union rallies, so many things, and it was always nice to be with you guys. Back then, which is something that I don't say so loud, because now as a leader, I'm not allowed to discriminate, but then I was allowed. It was completely unheard of, completely for the ladies that are here. Not as bad as that I say, but allow me to say it so that if that will motivate the young men that are here, so be it. It was completely unheard of back then to have the list of the institutions that have done well in the county. Then it used to be a district. And it be populated purely by girls' schools, which is what has happened in the last 5, 6, 7 years. I don't complain because I am a leader of both men and women. But in the gender debate, being a man, I'm on the men's side, and I need to see you guys at school. Even biblically, men are the leaders. So when we have women doing so well and men lagging behind, something is not so upbeat with that society. There's a problem. So I want our girls to succeed, but I also want you guys to succeed with them. That's my plea and my request. That next year, when I see the results of the county, don't let my body celebrate as a leader, but my heart to pump slowly as a man. No, I celebrate as a leader and say, yeah, the leader will done well, you have this tool, you have the other. But as a man inside, I'll be looking at where are the boys? Where is Kabianga? Where is Kericho High? Where is so and so? I'll be looking out for you guys. But from the projections that you've seen and what the principal was talking about, this particular exam, which you use as an indicator to tell you where you guys stand, things are looking up. Things are looking up. And I'm sure you guys will perform exceedingly well this year. I plead with you for the life that is in you. Please work hard. Many things you've been told over the time, but as an elder brother, allow me to say this to you. Life is not fair. It's only good and to those who work hard. The reality of life. In fact, if I was told, title your speech this morning to the students of Kabianga, I'll tell you that my thoughts to you are that life is not fair. It is only good to those who do what? It is only good to those who do what? Let me give you an example. Right now, we are facing a global pandemic. Are you aware? The whole world is battling COVID-19. The reason why COVID-19 is going to be perhaps easily extinguished in the next few months, because we've seen there are about 3 or 4 companies that have worked so hard and they are also succeeding in getting a vaccine, is because this disease has affected both Africans and the Western world. Flashback to about 5, 6, 7, 8 years, we had almost a disease of this magnitude called the Ebola outbreak. Did you guys hear about it when you were too young? You heard about Ebola. But because Ebola affected Africans only, up to now, no cure has been found. Who wants to find cure for poor people? Because even if you found cure, they can't afford to pay. That's how unfair life is. That's the reality of the world that we live in. Bring this topic home. Even in our country right now, the difference between those who are surviving COVID-19 and those who are dying, largely, to a great extent, though it's not 100% true, because money is not the sole assurance of you surviving COVID-19, but at least when you have money, it increases your chance of survival. If you fall sick, say, in Kericho, and you have the ways and the means to be rushed to a good hospital, you will survive. If you don't have the ways and the means, where people will bring you to the dispensary next to your home and take you back and say, oh, kuna kuombea. You disappear, my friend. That's the reality of life. I'm sorry, that's not the kind of world that maybe you guys expect you're walking into. But I have got not so very good news for you this morning. That's how life is. It is only fair to those who do what? Life is only fair to those who do what? You remember me for that simple discussion for the rest of your days, whenever we meet in future. That's the reality of life. And that's why I humbly want to plead with you, for the sake of the life that is in you, please work hard. You still have December, you have January, you have February. By March, when you sit your exams, when do the exams begin? 26th of March. You still have about roughly another 4 months to prepare and give your best shot. You know, it never matters how you begin, by the way. You know, there might be somebody who's in the assembly and is thinking, oh, I wish Senator had come here in 2017 when I was in Form 1. I would have done better in 1 or 2 things. But have you ever watched a marathon? It doesn't matter how you ran the first 41 kilometers. It's about how you finish. Nobody remembers Kipchoge, the world beating athlete. Ati vile uliona Zaida alikuwa kwa kilometer number 21 vile alikuwa ameenda. It doesn't matter. The final decision is when the whistle was blown, was he the first to the pick? You may have done exceedingly well, But now you are on the 42nd kilometer in the next 3 or 4 months. Everything that you've done, right from when you joined nursery, up to Form 4, up to Form 1, Form 2, Form 3, Form 4 first term, second term, is now about to be tested in the next 3 months. And unfortunately, that is that which will matter more than anything. That's the unfairness also. But remember earlier on when I began speaking, I told you life is not? I told you life is not? No, as an elder brother, I don't want to lie to you. That's why I say today, allow me to go to life. Speak to my young brothers, let me be truthful to them about the realities of life. I would have wished to tell you it's fair, but it's not. I'd have wished to tell even the 36 young men that were rewarded here this morning that since they are ahead, it is more than given that they will be ahead. But unfortunately, that is not true. They need to still put more effort in the next few months for them to still be rewarded. Otherwise, it wouldn't matter. Principal here will tell you, even if that result was to be projected elsewhere, in the determination of how you progress next, will the results of what was shared today feature? Will not feature, my good friend. So please, I plead with you. The next few days, tafadhali, wake up with me, so that we come and celebrate. Sitaki mchomo najua kuzidi hapo. I have said most of the things that I wanted to say. In conclusion, I celebrate each of you. And just to give you a taste that life is not fair, but it is good to those who know what. There are 36 boys that were awarded this morning. 36. I counted them. Each and every one of them. So I want to wait.